I did my qualification in Northwest University. My biggest dream was to become a nursery school teacher. Since I was a little girl, I wanted to become a teacher and a mom. So when I did my first dream, I qualified there, 4 years degree. I did my honors in general teaching and then in creativity to develop creativity in children. Started teaching, first 2 years I was a grade 2 teacher. Then I finally got a grade R position, which I was extremely excited about. Did that for 8 years. Also did the school readiness profiling course with Melody, and it was just amazing. I could just see the huge change in the children and how to help them. After testing children at the end of each year, the ones that are borderline or what late in the years, I've recognized that the parents are very, very against us trying to tell them that it's so important for your child to stay back. And it's in their best interest. It's got nothing to do with how powerful their minds are or how their God-given talents are developed. It's got extremely got to do with development. And after 7 years, 7.5 years, I decided that this is a losing battle. And I get emotionally attached too much to the children, and it's affecting my teaching ability, because I would just get so emotionally attached to that child that it's heartbreaking when I see them that they have to grow up, because it's completely in the parents' hands. We as teachers can provide the profile and the testing and all of that and the advice, but it's up to mom and dad to decide. And that's why it's so important for mom and dad to realize that they've got their child's life in their hands. And then I decided I'm done, I'm going to give up that dream and I'm going to go into foundation phase. And first I did Afrikaans teaching for grade 1s and 2s and 3s for 2 years, 3 years. And then I moved to grade 2 class, to a registered class. And I still get the emotional attachment with the kids and I still help them, but they on a level above the foundation phase. So there I get to help the little ones that are in the stream already, and I don't have to convince the mom and dad that they need to make this big choice for their child. So I get to help them and build their confidence in that year. And that's why I am asking you very nicely to please listen to your child's development and take the teacher's advice to heart. We don't just say it because we want to, we say it because we care and we love kids. That's why we do this. Thank you.